Brightside Group, the insurance broking and financial services company, recently announced a big change in share ownership at the company. The shares themselves have risen to levels not seen in something like 18 months. The chief executive is Martyn Holman, and he joins us now. Martyn, welcome.
Good morning.
I've got to talk about this change in share ownership because we've recently had Aaron Banks and John Gannon sell out their interest, pretty much sell out their interest in the business. What should investors take away from this?
I think it's a very positive message. We are certainly very pleased with the way in which things have developed in the last couple of months. Aaron is basically in a position now where he is moving on, focusing his efforts on his insurance company, Southern Rock, and their new vehicle, Go Skippy. Whilst we will continue to have a trading relationship with Southern Rock as a capacity provider for us, it does mean that a number of the issues that we were having around related parties are now well and truly buried. So Aaron made it clear that he wished to go that route. Fortunately, we had a lot of demand in the market for the stock, so much so, in fact, that it gave John Gannon the opportunity to also realise his asset after 11 years of, he would say, hard grind, and it gives him the opportunity to relocate back to Australia, which is what they've been, he and his family have been looking toward doing for a couple of years. So a win-win.
Yeah. One of the interesting moves out of this is the fact that Markerstudy now has 11% of Brightside. What's this mean for the company?
Again, very positive news. Markerstudy indicated probably a year ago that they were interested in maybe building a stake in the company. We do an increasing amount of business with them.
Now, this is an insurance company, isn't it? It's based in Gibraltar.
That's right, yes. They're a capacity provider for us and sit behind our e-car product. We also place a lot of business with them through our direct broking business. They like the model that we've got. They like the distribution model that we run. They like the fact that we're moving more heavily into the affinity space, and I actually just saw it as a way of taking a strategic stake, where you know they can develop the range of products that they have through our distribution base. In terms of the actual our placement strategy, that hasn't really changed. We will continue to use them. We will continue to use a full panel of insurers, as we've said to people, Aviva have had a stake in us from day one, so have Legal & General, and you know they have no real influence in terms of where we place business, and the same will be for Markerstudy.
Does all this help increase liquidity? Something when we last met you were talking about.
We certainly believe it will. This coupled with the share buyback provision that we've now has been approved through the shareholders last week means that we can be in control of the overhang, because there were a few pots of shares where they get dribbled out and it has a really negative effect on the price, and this actually we believe puts us right in the driving seat to be able to control that it gives us the wherewithal to actually go out and try and extend the shareholder base. So we will be doing a number of roadshows into private client brokers and private clients over the next couple of months.
Again, anybody looking at the previous interview we did with your FD and yourself, you were looking there at record earnings. And I noticed actually from your recent trading update showed your forecast to meet expectations of strong growth in revenue and profits and follow up again on your maiden interim dividend.
Yes, absolutely. And we made it clear that we wish to adopt a progressive dividend policy. And so we will be announcing the next stage of that when we release our numbers in second week in April. We were very pleased with the performance in 2012. There were clearly a lot of things going on, should we say, off the field around the management. And I think, you know, we'd said at the time that it had to be business as usual. There were no excuses for people within the business to not deliver. And full credit to them, they have delivered, and that's really good. And we've got a very strong base now moving into 13 and beyond.
Well, you still say the business is undervalued. By what criteria do you set that assessment?
I think it's a frustration, really. If you look at when we floated 5 years ago with profits of 600,000 The share price was 19p, mm-hmm. And now we're posting profits of, 12.5 million. up until last week or week before, it was 22p. Yeah, So, you have to draw your own conclusions. There were reasons for it, and certainly the related party issues, etc., weren't helping. But I'd like to think that we've kind of knocked over those dominoes one by one, and so we're in a position now where things can really move forward.
One of the things you're doing as a management team is you're looking for ways to other companies to white label products that you back. Your e-car, I think, was one thing you're talking about, and that's going now to Asda, isn't it? And also Debenhams, I believe.
Absolutely right.
How much of a part of your business is this?
It will become an increasing part. What we're looking to do with this is to use this actually as our growth engine. So it's not that we're thinking, oh, well, that will become a larger piece of the existing pie. We are looking to make the pie significantly bigger. We believe that there are big growth opportunities in the e-commerce and affinity space. We've restructured the business so that that now sits as its own individual P&L. And the expectation for that this year is that it will deliver us some attractive numbers.
We'll certainly look forward to those numbers when they come out. What else should investors watch out for as this year moves on?
I think that we are where we've got a focus on e-commerce and affinity, that is largely being led by improvements to our system to get the scalability to a point where we can really turn the taps on just derive the income without the accompanying expense. On our direct broking proposition, I think we're still very, very strong in the SME market, and we believe that there are big opportunities there for us as well going forward, to the degree that we would hope to have some web front-ended liability product, shop product, that type of thing, as we go through the year, which we believe will give us further impetus in that sector.
Okay, so one final question. Where do we go from here?
Well, I think it's fair to say we are very, very bullish about 2013 and beyond. We've got great growth opportunities, we believe, in the online part of our business, whilst also still being able to get the similar sort of levels of organic growth in our direct broking proposition. We have removed a number of the barriers that were seen in terms of the share price through the related parties and with the share buyback. So all in all, we are very, very optimistic, both in terms of business performance and shareholder value.
Well, we look forward to the news as it comes out as the year progresses. But Martin, in the meantime, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Jeremy.
It's Martin Holman. He's Chief Executive of Brightside Group.